Hi, welcome to this demo on a receiver for a sign request. A receiver is a person that receives information on the status changes on the sign request. So let's take a look. To configure the receiver, we first have to make sure that the pick list value on the global value set for the role is activated. So you have to see this overview here, both the signer and the receiver. And they both have to be active values. Okay, when that is done, you can just go to a sign request template, and I have prepared one for this demo. And in this sign request template, you can of course set all of the information that we want. And in this case, our receiver information comes from the opportunity. We want that the owner of the opportunity is actually the receiver of our of status updates. So if we go to the opportunity, we see in this case the owner is myself, and I want to be updated about anything that happens with this opportunity and the signing of this opportunity. So I do the configuration. I'm going to go here on next, and on next you can see that I already added a receiver. In the receiver configuration, it's just the same as the signer configuration. You select the data source and you set all of the information that is required. So make sure that the ID of this setting here is a user, a contact, or a lead. In most cases, a receiver will be a user because it's somebody internally that wants to be notified. So in this case, it's the owner ID of my opportunity. You have to indicate when do you want to be notified. Maybe a notification on creation is not that important for you, so you, because you send it out manually and then you know that it's created. If you have multiple signers, you might want to know that every time somebody has signed, you get a notification. So that means that the document is signed by somebody, but it's not finished yet. So not all of the signers have signed it. Then, if you want to be notified on every signer that signs, well, just click this signed button checkbox. When you want to be notified when it's finished or rejected, so it reaches an end stage, the sign request is completely signed by all signers, of course, then you just check this one. This is the most common one, of course, that you want to know. And then you might also want to know when the reminders are set, when the warnings are sent, when the sign request is expired. You just want to be updated on all of these different statuses. Okay, so just that's the configuration. Now I add my receiver again, and I can just save my my configuration by clicking the submit button. Now, complete configuration is there. Then the next step is just, of course, creating in PDF Butler a pack that uses this sign request template. So let's go back to PDF Butler, and in PDF Butler I have already a pack called one signer and one receiver, and in this pack I, as normal, have my doc config set, of course, and I have an actionable for the sign request. To launch the sign request. So this is just a normal actionable on the sign request that you would normally do, and I select my template for the one signer and one receiver. Next step is we add this this package to our page layouts of the opportunity. In this case, we want to add it to the to the previewer. Maybe let's take a look if it's already added. Yeah, so I have added it here. If you want to know how it's added, then it's just here, of course, in the edit page. And in the edit page, I have selected to add my pack. And this is my one signer, one receiver pack on the previewer as an extra action. Okay, let's test this. So if I now send out, first I want to see the preview, then I want to send out my one signer and one receiver. As you can see, I have only one signing placeholder here. It's a very lightweight demo. I click the button. Now it will prepare the sign request and send it out to everybody that needs to sign it. In this case, the person that has to sign it is Jack Rogers, and the person that's the receiver is Igor Stavr. So let's take a look at the sign request, because all of the information is right there. Oh, I have to go here. So let's take a look at new sign request. So this sign request was created right now. And if I look at the overview, I see that two mails were sent. A mail was sent to Jack Rogers in German. So we have configured that Jack is German speaking, and Jack needs to sign the document. But also a mail was sent to Igor Stavr, who is the owner of the opportunity, to say that, hey, the sign request was created. So in this case, we have already sent two emails to notify Igor as a receiver, and to Jack to sign the document. Okay, Jack will have received this mail in his inbox, of course, but just for demo purposes, I'm gonna sign it via this, via Salesforce. So click on the email, and then we are ready to sign. Of course, the experience for Jack is exactly the same here. So we have not set multiple languages. That's why his overview is in English, although he's German speaking. If we have multiple languages set, it would be in German, of course. And then he can just sign the document. Okay, Jack Rogers, I take a signature part, and then I'm gonna sign the document. After signing the document, me as a receiver should also receive an email, not only Jack. Let's take a look at the sign request, refresh the page, and I can see the status is finished, so everything is signed. And if all went well, then also I got an notification that's right here. So me as a receiver got a notification that all of the signers signed the document, and also I got a notification, of course, and Jack got a notification that his document was signed and he can download the document. So that's a demo on the receiver.